YouTube fam, welcome back to my channel. It has been a long time, but I believe I am back and ready to start making videos again. If you are new here, I hope you stick around, and if you like what you see, please subscribe. And if you are a returner, thank you so much for sticking around while I was gone. I hope you guys enjoy this video. We're gonna get right into it.
What's up, YouTube fam? Welcome back to another video. It's been forever, and guess where we are? We're traveling. Which way? This way? Oh, this way. Okay. Thank you. This is very nice. Look at this. Very nice. On the boat. We made it, little shawty. All right, so now we need to find our room. Our key is here. My bag doesn't have feet. Just tear it. Just rip it. Is the boat moving? I feel vibrations. Oh, ew. Why did I get red? We got little keys. How cute is that? Okay. Oh, there's music playing. Oops. Okay. And here's our little room. That little couch. Interesting. Okay. Oh, TV. Obviously, we know it's not the Hilton, but it'll do. Let's see. We got a little balcony, Kelvin. Mm-hmm. Say, we got a balcony.
We got
a sun.
Huh?
A sun. It's how beautiful. Ooh. Is it? Did we take off?
No, it's just the waves.
Let me hold on to my phone, y'all.
If you guessed it, we are on a cruise.
We made it, Jesus. Y'all, when I tell you this has been the most interesting travel experience we have had in all of our...
Pushing it to the limit.
But God, right? We're going on a cruise. We're traveling to 4 different places. So we're going to be hitting San Juan, Puerto Rico, St. Kitts, St. Martin, and the Grand Turk. And so I'm super, super excited. We were supposed to travel in December, but unfortunately I had a death in the family, and so we had to reschedule. So here we are now. It's my spring break. We're out of school, so no teaching this week. So we are gonna enjoy ourselves on the Carnival Freedom. So I'm super, super excited. We're porting out of Miami, or embarking out of, is that the correct word? We're at the port of Miami, okay? It's embarkment day, that's what I'm trying to say. And we should be leaving here literally in like the next 3 minutes, okay? Because it is no. I think we leave at 3:30. Don't quote me, I'll figure it out. But let's get settled in real quick, and then I'll be back to catch up with you guys. All right, so the lady was trying to tell us something when we came here that we have to do. Because obviously, you know, we were the last people on board. Or almost the last people on board. We were in that last boarding crew, okay? It went no lines, no nothing. So we're about to go figure out what that is, and then we're gonna explore the boat. So I'm gonna take y'all along. Kelvin's getting his life together. I'm starving, so we need to find some food. And the person said lunch is about to be served. All right, so we found the food. The outside, I think. So, oh. Shopping bar, all kind of stuff over here. Yeah, chili, and then I think this is very nice. Okay, I got a thing telling us to wash our hands. That's our boat name. Feels good out here. Okay,
There's a little slide that the kids can use, all kind of stuff. Oh, a bar. Okay. I think this is the pool, but it doesn't have any water in it. Oh, there's another bar. Maybe some drinks. And yeah, very nice. I'm gonna go over here. Let's travel over here and see what we see. So now we're on the top deck. And you can see Miami. It's a great day, all the pretty houses. And then our boat. So yeah, this is one side of the deck. Our room is way on the other end, way down there. We had to walk. But yeah, this is it. And not sure what's up there. I guess there's more stuff up there. But like I said, we're gonna explore. They have a little jacuzzi, two jacuzzis.
Wanted to sit in the sun, but yeah. It's hot. It's hot. It's hot. I underestimated the sun here.
He'll do anything, right? All right, now I don't know if you know this, but you can do the electric slide to pretty much any song. Now we are gonna be celebrating Carnival's 50th birthday during this sail-away. We're going through the decades and some of the best music, and we got one to do the electric slide too. Here we go, DJ Am. Get those hands clapping.
Y'all a little room tour. So you gotta do angles in here basically because it's small. So we have a little closet with some shelves here, extra blanket, shout out to the full body mirror. Okay, then we have hers closet, got some hangers, got our life jacket, my stuff, his closet, hangers, life jacket. Okay, then here is the bathroom. Is the light gonna come on? So we have this teeny tiny shower. Here's the shower. Okay, it comes with shampoo and shower gel. All right, shower. That's how much space you have. Then we have the toilet area and the sink. And then, like, you got some stuff under there. Whoa. Okay. And they have a little desk or whatever. Lord, Kelvin, you brought the sanitizer? You ain't got no plugs. There's only two plugs in here. Ooh, the boat's starting to sway. Okay. We have a little sitting area. They gave us some towels. All right. Then we have a bed. And then we have a balcony room, so you go out. We have a lovely little port window. Well, that's not a port window, but nice little window. Oh, I forget it's push. Then you come out, and we are out here now. So we're like, boom. I don't want to stand too close. But yeah, you can see Miami is behind us. And the beautiful ocean, the water is like really blue and pretty. It's like that deep, rich blue. It's so pretty. And we're just out in the ocean. And then we have some balcony chairs out here for us to sit and relax.
All right, gotta take a little nappy nap because the sun got me. So, hey, girl. So we are out in the boat now. Finding things. So we just walked through a whole bunch. I'll go back through there. But we saw the casino. We saw a lot of the bars and things like that. It's really nice. Then we we made it to like the atrium of the boat, like the middle of the boat, and we're here. Ooh, it's rocking, y'all. All right, this is the 70s club. It's a little nightclub, so I guess we'll check this out. Hopefully it's not just 70s music, but it's nice and spacious in here. It has a nice little dance floor, little seating area. Kelvin said Vegas vibes. I don't think quite that, but
a lot of sections.
Oh yeah, the sections, but so that's cool.
That's Miami,
I guess so.
Miami. Section,
yeah. They have several like little picture things that you can take. So they have a little arcade. Let's go in here. A little arcade. I about to say win you a PS5, but got some stuff in here. Miami Vice, and he got a Manhattan, a toast
to future M's.
Future ends, money, mansions, what else? Moguls.
Moves.
Pretty good. I've never had pina colada before. How did that happen? I'm probably still doing strawberry, but the pina colada is not bad. All right, we are at dinner. It's really nice in here. Tonight is a casual night, so I just have one of my favorite sweatshirts, Hogwarts. Let me show y'all what it looks like. So this is the part of the ship where we have dinner. We're in the aft, which is like the back of the ship. And they have like this really pretty roof and everything. And yeah, everybody's seated. We're at table 444. Not sure if there's other people that are gonna sit with us, but it's just us. They've brought us bread so far and water, and we scan the menu. Can I see your phone? This is just a glimpse of the menu real quick. Looking at cocktails. They have dessert, steak selections from the grill, roasted chicken, beef brisket. I'm thinking about the roasted chicken, and some appetizers, salad, all that stuff. So yeah, pretty good menu. I know we'll be here enough days to try a little bit of everything. What are you thinking so far?
Either the roast chicken or glazed beef brisket.
How about we each get one? Because I was thinking the roasted chicken or that too.
Okay.
I call the chicken. I'm gonna try the bread. All right, we got our entree. He got Caesar salad. I got regular salad. He said mixed greens. I'm thankful it's not a lot of those weird greens like arugula and all of that, because I don't like that. So let us taste and see. All right. Now, the main dish is here. The salad was bomb.com, besides the little greens I don't eat. And like I said, I got roast chicken on potatoes and zucchini. Kelvin got the beef brisket with the mash and vegetables. So let's taste and see what the carnival food is tasting like. On this episode of Trying New Foods with Autumn, we are trying Carnival's roast chicken. Now the cherry chicken part. Dessert. First bite was a little dry. We got some potatoes.
Okay, I'll need a little salt. Lamb. But I'm gonna get some seasoning, it should be fine. I'll give it like a 7. Kelvin got a bad plate. Pork it. So like most of his meat was ended up being fat. Like it wasn't even briskety fat.
I ended up with 2 pieces of brisket.
Yeah, that basically everything else is fat. So that was not good.
You know I don't do fat.
He does not do fat.
Now that's a brisket. He must have had the butt of that last one because it was all.
It was just white.
Yeah, it was.
Okay, the brisket is actually really good now that he has a decent brisket. I'd give it like an 8. It could maybe use a little kick of flavor. It has like a sauce on it that makes it really good. But the meat itself could use a little bit more of something. But yeah, that's good. And so my fruit came now. So I'm going to eat my fruit. And hopefully it's nice and fresh. I had some watermelon earlier and it was really yummy. And so I have a pineapple here. And then I think I have some little oranges and some strawberries. All right, so now we are headed to, I think, the Victoria or the Victorian. What is it? Victoria, whatever it is up there. It's a Welcome Abroad show. So we're gonna look for seedy seats. I don't wanna sit right there, Kelvin.
You can step forward. Go ahead and step forward as well. All right. So when I say go, you are going to shake everything you've got. All right. Try to get those ping pong balls out. You're going to get 60 seconds on the clock. Now, whatever couple can get through all of them first, or by the end of the 60 seconds have the least amount of ping pong balls in their box, will be our winner. All right. You ready? Are you ready? Excellent. Audience, are you ready? Yeah. All right, you're going to help me count it down in 3, 2, 1, go! Shake it, shake it, shake it. Yes, yes. There it is. Yeah. Oh, wow. Keep it going. There's still one in there. Shake it. It's stuck in there. There's one in there. See, it's right there. See, it's right there. There's one in there. Your incredible cast of the Welcome Abroad show.
Right? Like, you got black kids, bro? You got, you're black. That's a dumbass question. You got kids. Fucking 1 year old. Dang, and you're 32? See, this proves that white people don't age well. Like, he aged like fine wine. You like an avocado. You're 61? Okay, what happened to your fingers, bro? You put it in the wrong...
We just left the comedy show and decided to come get some food. What is this? Lemonade? Before we head back to the room to go to sleep. And I'm super tired. So we got chicken noodle soup and I'm gonna try this penne pasta. It looks interesting, but we'll see. Good morning, beautiful people. It is day 2 on layboat. Sorry I did not close out last night because the girl was tired. I think we got back to the room at like, what, 11:30, 12-ish? After searching for food. Oh, let me talk about the food on the boat, okay? Food on the boat right now is like a 6. So just keep that in mind if you're trying to cruise. And I also think it also depends on what cruise you're doing. I've never done anything but Carnival, so I can't speak to other food experiences. And I don't remember, honestly, when I was 14 and we went on a cruise. But right now, my taste buds are giving the food a 6. It's not that the food is bad, it's that the food is bland. And that's because, obviously, everybody has different dietary restrictions. So they can't just make the food like, you know, how you would make it at home. But, you know, a little flavor wouldn't be so bad on some of the things. Really, it's just adding a little salt. But the comedy show was super good. I literally wish I could have recorded the whole thing. He was so freaking funny. But yeah, that was a really good event. So there's some other events that we've marked on our planner today for boat activities because we still have 2 days at sea. We have passed through the Bahamas, although we didn't really get to see that much of it because it was dark by the time we passed through there. Right now, I'm literally looking out the window and all there is Atlantic water. Really blue, pretty water, but lots of water. So we're trying to figure out what we're going to wear because we're about to go to Brunchy Brunch. Because we definitely slept in. It's about 11:30 almost. So we are going to get dressed for brunch and then we'll probably just head to the deck and see what we can get into. So I just wanted to check in and, you know, I'll be back with whatever we decide to do. All right, my hair is still in my face because it hasn't shrunk yet, but now I look like the guy off of Simpsons. Okay, day 2. I'm getting ready to finally venture out. Kelvin is now finally ready. Just want to state for the record that I was ready for once. Does that look weird? Puff puff today, yeah. Finally got our money on our card because when we got on board yesterday, my credit was not on my card, so but luckily what I did spend on my regular card they credited out of the money that was available. So we're gonna spend some of that today. Got our tacos.
That's what's gonna go on.
I got it now. Go ahead and get yours. I got chicken tacos.
Kelvin got a chicken taco and a Mongolian bowl or whatever. course, he has us sitting in the smoker section because he wanted to sit by the water. And I'm going to try to enjoy this, and then I'm going to move. I didn't know they had on the boat. They have this adult only retreat called Serenity, so you have to be 21 and over to get over here. And so yeah, they have completely different chairs, like little blue on them. They have little cabanas back here, super cute. We gotta go down this way, and then down here, see, they have all the seating, the chairs, water over here, and they have complimentary water pretty much everywhere. Bahama Mama strawberry daiquiri, toasty toast.
Too fun.
Too fun on the fun ship.
Fun. Didn't taste mine. Look at my toes. They look good. I love the color. And child, a black woman did my feet. Okay. We love it. She really did a good job on my toes. I love them. It's almost time for dinner, so we probably will go. Well, I will probably go back to the room, get ready for dinner. And tonight is elegant night, so we got huge wrist. So I gotta figure out what I'm gonna wear. Brought a couple of things, so we'll see. I actually still don't know my room number. I know it's 60 something 41, but I don't know the other number, the one after the first six. I just know what door it is. 60, I think it's 64, 61. I think that's what it is. That's not my room. That's not my room. Maybe I'm 65, 40. Oh, 6453, I think. Merry Christmas. I think this is my room. I'm not sure. That was definitely not my room. I'm 6461. Key out here on the balcony. Did you go in? Okay, I was about to say. All right, it is dinner time. Tonight is formal. So I have on this little black dress and these little, I don't know what these are, but, and then
these shoes. and a little bit of makeup. And we're headed to dinner. So that's a better outfit thingy. So that's what I have on. Comfy, but cute.
All right, appetizer. I got shrimp cocktail. He got blackened. What was it? Blackened.
What was
pork
it?
Tart.
Pork tart. Looks very interesting. You got one little shrimpy left. Kelvin ate the pork, but he didn't eat the rest of it. It was like a supposed to be a pineapple something and like a citrus cream. I tasted that yellow, but I don't know. It was both giving us deviled egg vibes, don't you think? It was. Don't it look like the inside of a deviled egg thing? The yolk stuff or whatever that stuff is? The filling. But it don't taste like that though.
Okay, we got prime rib here. I was not expecting it to be this red, but Kelvin said that's normal, so. And then he got some grilled salmon. You need some juice or something on it. A little dry. Oh, okay, a little dry. But yeah, let us taste and see. Let's taste and see what the prime rib is talking about. Almost on my fork. Interesting. I'm just a little worried about it being this pink. Are you sure? Like, look how pink that is. Y'all can't really see that. Let me see.
Does it feel?
No. It's not bloody or anything. It's just pink. It's just odd that it's so pink, but it's not bloody or anything, so I guess that must mean it's cooked. Maybe it's like brisket, because you know brisket is pink.
It's a thing. Upper level brisket, I think.
Oh, okay. Interesting. Okay, so a guy next to me ended up getting the prime rib too, and his was brown, and that was medium. This was definitely medium rare, and I knew I should have asked because it was too red. It was still good, but I'm full now, so. How's your, what's that called? How's your, salmon?
It was good for no seasoning.
It was good for no seasoning? But he put the Tabasco on it, as he always does, so.
Listen, she is going to sing for us tonight, followed by the Tabasco.
Lizzo.
Music, please.
Did you say Lizzo?
No.
So hopefully it's good, because y'all know the food has been interesting here.
I got French toast, I got some fruit, and some sausage. They had a lot of other things. They have an omelet station, they had pancakes, they had egg benedict or ham benedict, scrambled eggs, hard-boiled eggs, bacon, all that good stuff. Kelvin got
ham, bacon, and pancake.
We decided to not buy any excursion packages and just figure out what to do once we get on the island, because he ran into a frat brother last night and I was talking to the girlfriend who was a Delta, and you know, I'm AKA. And so we were all chit-chatting and they were saying like this was their third cruise together. He's like 20-something. But she was just saying it's better just to buy excursions from the locals because it's 10 times cheaper than what you'll buy through the cruise liner. So I think we're going to try to do that instead of buying these. Unless you want to buy an excursion. Like if there's something you really want to do on there, it doesn't matter to me. Okay, she's not answering. But yeah, so I guess we'll figure that out. Today I'm not sure what we're going to do. Especially with the cloud coverage like this, because when I sat on the balcony this morning, it was a little nippy. I know he wants to play mini golf, and I guess we'll see what events are having today, and then we'll go from there. That's currently where we are in the middle of nowhere. Look at, there we are. So, I've been finding our pictures. Oh, wow. This is the basic steak, like no charge, no up charge. What is it? Strip loin? Strip loin steak with vegetables and mashed potatoes and some type of sauce. And then that's Kelvin chicken breast, y'all. So we're gonna see what it tastes like. Now, if that wasn't hilarious, Kelvin asked for some ranch for his chicken and some green tea to drink, and they misunderstood him and brought him some green peas. We were both looking like, what? But he said he gonna eat them. You like peas, Kel?
Peas, I got peas, bottle peas, any peas.
What's some peas you be getting?
Rubber peas.
Those, yeah. I ain't never heard of those in my life before. Green peas.
I have not been closing out at the end of the day. This is my first closeout. Tomorrow we make it to our first island, St. Martin. Really excited. I hope I feel better because my nose is getting ready to fall off. It's been stuffy and running, and I don't know what it means, but it's fall time to me. Kelvin went to go iron the clothes for tomorrow, and I'm just laying here. I need to get in the shower, but the way my nose is set up right now, the shower may help, but I'm also tired, so I don't know. So I just wanted to close it out. I will catch up with you guys in Le Morning when we get to the island. Say it with me, the island. So excited. But until then, sleep tight. Toodle-ay.